Hey guys, today we're going to modify my Yoder Wichita from needing a water pan to going to a water smoker. So we all know about having the benefits of a water pan in your smoker, whether it be a pellet smoker, a offset stick burner, even a Weber, and the list probably goes on. The water vapor in a smoker, not only does it help keep the meat moist, it helps stabilize the temperatures in the cooking chamber. And I'm not going to get into the scientific reason for it. There's a few channels out there that really do get into the scientific reasons for it. But I think after you've smoked on a cooker where they've used a water pan, you obviously know the benefits. But we don't always necessarily like dealing with a pan. A lot of times you find yourself going in the kitchen and robbing your wife of one of her nice little meatloaf pans, which is what this used to be. So a lot of the higher end smokers actually have ball valves as an option. Some come with them, others you have to pay extra for. I'm going to show you how to do a quick retrofit on my loaded Yoder Wichita. It's really easy to do. It just requires a few simple tools, small investment on your part, and a little bit of time. All right guys, here's the basic components of my kit. Okay, this is all basically revolving around this lead-free brass ball valve. It's one and a quarter inch. And I'm using kind of a downpipe, 1 1/4 inch black steel pipe nipple, 4 inches long. This is obviously optional. Definitely some eye and hearing protection because we're gonna be using power tools. Get yourself some gloves. And then you're gonna need a center punch before you drill this hole in the pipe. Okay, because that's what we're going to be doing. You need a 1/13-64 inch drill and a 1/4 inch drill, obviously a drill. And then what we're going to be doing is tapping the hole in the Yoder's grease drain, which is about an inch and a half outer diameter. And that's what this ball valve is going to slip over. And I'll show you how we're going to attach it here in a minute. So the 1/4 inch bit is for drilling a couple holes on either side of the ball valve flange here, okay? And then through that hole, we're gonna be putting these 1/4-20 stainless steel screws into the 1/4-20 tapped Yoder cleanout pipe. Okay, so that's how we're gonna be doing that. Obviously the hammer is for the tap. You got a power drill, a 7/16 wrench or wrench of your choice, you know, obviously to screw this down. And what we're gonna use to seal that ball valve to the Yoder is some ultra black gasket maker. You know, I got some of this Loctite all temperature laying around as well. I might use that. Just make sure you get something that's for automotive use or something that's rated for higher heat. You know, it'll help out in longevity and stuff like that. And as you could see, this whole method that I'm using here is reversible. You'll be able to, by just taking these screws out, remove it if you have to. But with the ball valve, it's going to be a real simple proposition to just dump the valve and drain your water out of your smoker, even when you clean it. So it gives you a little option there. And some kind of cutoff wheel, hacksaw or whatever, cutoff tool, because the Yoder has the hanger for the grease bucket. And obviously after this modification, you're never gonna have to use a grease bucket again until it comes time to actually drain the grease. So, all right guys, so let's get started.
Thank you.
right, guys, here we go. It's a finished product. A couple things I needed to do a little differently. Wasn't a big deal. I just had to widen the holes a little bit on the ball valve side. I used a couple lock washers just for safety. You know, I didn't use any Loctite because I don't think this thing is going to be shaking too much unless I got some bomb and barbecue. And it was a really tight spot, so I had a little trouble getting that tapping wrench in there. So I ended up just kind of using a small box end wrench, open end wrench, and you know, made it work. So other than that, I think it came out pretty good. I'm going to let this thing set up for at least 48 to 72 hours before I cook on it, because of the RTV silicone. But I bet that it's going to be really solid once it does set up. And I'm probably going to touch up some of this black pipe down here with a little bit of barbecue paint, or just keep it oiled down and let it naturally patina. And now your smoker has another little valve to work, which is kind of cool. So up is off, down is open. And if you guys got some little kids there, like to throw switches and stuff like that, you might want to paint it red, get a little remove before flight little banner on here. It'd look pretty cool. But that'd be pretty tragic to let somebody just dump it, you know. So maybe keep a bucket over there, you know, if you don't trust your neighbors and friends and stuff. Hey, anyway, guys, Sassy Kitchen Queen's got a great dinner tonight, so I'm running a little bit late. Hope you appreciate this little tutorial. I'm going to leave a complete parts description down in the links in the description. So go check it out. Post any questions you might have. And I'd love to see you guys over at Greenhornbbq Beer Discussions Facebook group and post pictures of your smoker mods and stuff like that, because that's really what we're into here. I like tinkering in the backyard as much as the next guy. So if you would, ladies and gentlemen, please like and subscribe this video. Hit that bell so you don't miss a thing, and we'll see you on the next one.